Hello student, in last video we complete development of female gametophyte, and in last 6 video we complete male gametophyte and female gametophyte. In this video we study about pollination, fertilization and development of endosperm and embryo. Okay, let we start pollination. First of all we start pollination. What is pollination? Definition of pollination: the process of transfer of pollen grain from pollen sac of stamen to the stigma of carpel is termed as pollination. So what is pollination? The transfer of pollen grain from the anther to stigma is known as pollination. Liberation of pollen grain from the pollen sac is essential for pollination. Transfer of pollen grain from pollen sac to stigma take place by various means such as insect, wind, water, birds, bats, snail, etc. Okay, these are agencies of pollinations. Okay, different kind of agencies are responsible for the pollination. For example, insect, wind, water, birds, bats, snail, etc. Okay, now we move on types of pollination. Types of pollination. There are two types of pollination: cell pollination and cross pollination. Cell pollination and cross pollination. First of all we study about cell pollination. When pollen grain of a flower are transferred to the stigma of the same flower or to the stigma of other flower of the same plant it is known as self pollination. Cell pollination may be of two types. Okay, now by the help of diagram we study about cell pollination. Suppose this is a flower. In this flower anther are present, stamens are present, and this is stigma. If the pollen grain are pollinated from the anther to the stigma of same flower, and suppose here one more flower is present, if the anther the pollen grain of the anther are pollinated from the anther to the stigma of another flower of same plant. So this type of pollination is known as self pollination. Okay friend, now we discuss about cell pollination may be of two types: autogamy. When pollen grain of a flower reach the stigma of same flower, for example, a flower is pollinated by its own pollen grain, for example, pea plant. In pea plant, which type of pollination is present? Cell pollination. And type of cell pollination? Autogamy. Autogamy means same flower. Second is geotonogamy. When pollen grain of a flower are transferred on the stigma of other flower on the same plant, it is called as geotonogamy. This pollination takes place between two different flower of a plant. From hereditary point of view, it is cell pollination. Genetically, it is cell pollination. But from ecological view, majority of botanists consider it as cross pollination. Ecologically, it is cross pollination because flower are different. Okay, flower are different. But genetically means if the plant is same plant, so genetical association is always same. Okay, so genetically it is cell pollination, but ecologically it is cross pollination. For example, maize and cucumber, they show which type of cell pollination? Geotonogamy type of pollination. By the help of this diagram, this is a maize plant. In this diagram, cross pollination and cell pollination both are shown out. Autogamy means when the pollen grain are liberated on the same flower or different flower of same plant. If the pollen grain are introduced on the stigma of other flower of other plant. Okay, so this is called cross pollination. Okay, autogamy and geotonogamy is the type of self pollination. It is called autogamy and it is called geotonogamy. Now we discuss about contrivances or adaptation of cell pollination. Okay, adaptation, which type of adaptation for self pollination? First is bisexuality. Bisexuality. Such plants are generally hermaphrodite, or their flowers are bisexual. Bisexual means male and female, both the sex organ are present in a flower. For example, pea plant. Okay, homogamy. In such plant, both androecium and gynoecium of a flower mature simultaneously, and at the same time of diffusion of pollen sac, the stigma become receptive, so that there is full possibility of self-pollination. Self-pollination. Homogamy means when male reproductive part and female reproductive part both are mature at same time. So this condition is known as homogamy. Next is cleistogamy. Cleistogamy. In some plant, their flower never open, rather remain closed always. Therefore, in such plants, self-pollination is the only possibility. For example, some species of viola and comelina, etc. Okay, in the viola and comelina, which type of self-pollination is present? Cleistogamy type of self-pollination is present. Now we move on, second type of pollination, cross-pollination. Cross-pollination. When the pollen grain of the flower of one plant are transferred to the stigma of flower of another plant of the same species. Species are same, okay, of the same species, it is called as cross-pollination. From the technically point of view, this is termed as genogamy. Genogamy. Okay, technically point of view, the cross-pollination is also known as genogamy. Genogamy. Important point. Okay, genogamy. Now, contrivances or adaptations for cross-pollination. Which type of adaptation for cross-pollination are there? Many devices and adaptations in plant always favor for cross-pollination, which are as follow. First is self-sterility. Self-sterility. These are very, very important in neat point of view. Self-sterility. In the flower of same plant, the pollen grain produced by same flower do not germinate on the stigma of the flower itself. Despite all adaptation, it is called self-sterility. For example, Passiflora, Vitis, Petunia species. Okay, Petunia species. Passiflora, Vitis, Vitis means Angur. Okay, and Petunia species. Next is unisexuality or declinae. Okay, unisexuality. Due to unisexuality in all the flower of plants, cross-pollination is one only possibility, because in a flower, either male or female reproductive organ is found. It may be noted that many plants such as ribbon gourd, loofah and bottle gourd, Legionaria, both type of unisexual flower are produced on the same plant. Cross-pollination in such cases is geitonogamy type, which is considered as type of self-pollination. Self-pollination means male and female, both the flower are separate, but they are present on same plant. So this type of pollination is technically it is a cross-pollination, but genetically it is a self-pollination. Next is dichogamy. What is dichogamy? In the flower of same plant, androecium and gynoecium mature at different time. This is known as dichogamy. This is of two type. Protandry. First type is protandry. When pollen sac of a flower mature earlier than its stigma. Okay, very important. Read this line again. When pollen sac of a flower mature earlier than its stigma, means the male reproductive part is mature before, first of all, and the female reproductive part is mature after the maturation of male reproductive part. It is termed as protandry. For example, China rose, cotton, sunflower, etc. Okay, this type of this is also a type of cross pollination. Second type is protogyny. Protogyny, when stigma of a flower matures earlier than its pollen sac, it is termed as protogyny. For example, majority of plant belonging to family Brassicaceae, cruciferi family or Brassicaceae or Rosaceae family. Okay, and Ficus bengalensis, bergat, Ficus bengalensis. In this type of plant, protogyny condition is present. What is protogyny? Female reproductive part is mature earlier as comparison to male reproductive part. This condition is known as protogyny. Now, harcogamy. Harcogamy. When there is any type of structural barrier between the stigma, and pollen sac, due to which self pollination is not possible, it is known as harcogamy. For example, in many plant of family Caryophyllaceae, the length of style is significantly more in comparison to stamen, due to which self pollination is not possible. In Gloriosa, dehiscence of pollen sac is such that pollen grain are seed at far distance place. Thus, self pollination is not possible. Okay, what is harcogamy? When stigma is large in size and stamen length is short in size, it is not possible the pollen grains are introduced on stigma. So this type of pollination, cross pollination, is known as harcogamy. Second type of heterostyle. Two type of flower are found in primula. In one type of flower, style is longer than and stamen are smaller, while in the second type of flower, the style is shorter and stamen are longer. Okay. Thus, self pollination is not possible in such flower, as stigma of longer style can be pollinated by the pollen grain of longer stamens, and stigma of shorter style carpel can be pollinated by the pollen grain of smaller stamen. This is called heterostyle. Now we study about methods of cross pollination. In cross pollination, transfer of pollen grain is dependent on external agencies. These external agencies may be abiotic, means wind or water, or biotic, insect, birds, animals. On the basis of these external agencies, cross pollination may be of the following type. First is anemophily. Very, very important, these agencies. Okay, anemophily. When transfer of pollen grain is through the agencies of wind, it is known as anemophily. Which type of agency? Wind, abiotic agency. This is called anemophily. The pollen grain of wind pollinated plants are small sized, light weighted, with smooth and dry surface. They are produced in enormous number. The stigma of wind pollinated flower has adaptation for receiving pollen grain. For example, in grasses, the stigma is feathery, and in typha, stigma is brush like. Okay. So some adaptations is also present in the stigma, so they accept the pollen grain. Second type is hydrophily. When transfer of pollen grain is by water, this type of pollination is known as hydrophily. It is termed as hydrophily. Generally, all aquatic plants are not pollinated by the agency of water. For example, aquatic plants such as Potamogeton and Myrophyllum are wind pollinated. Similarly, Nymphaea and an aquatic plant is insect pollinated plant. Hydrophily is generally of two types. First is hypohydrophily. hydrophily. When pollination takes place underwater, it is called as hypohydrophily. Nages, okay, joystra, etc. are submerged plants. Submerged means डूबे हुए plants, and in these plants only hydrophily pollination is found. Second type is epihydrophily. When flower is pollinated on the surface of water, it is known as epihydrophily. For example, Vallisneria. Third type of pollination is entamophily. Many type of insects such as bees, moths, butterflies, wasps, beetles, etc. help in entamophily. Approximately 80% entamophily is carried out by bees. Shining colored, nectar filled odors and attractive flowers are generally found in the entamophilous plants. For example, mustard, salvia, orchids and calotropis are some of the plants which are entamophilous. Orchids, calotropis. Now next type is ornithophily. Many of the tropical plants are pollinated by birds. Flower in these plants are tubular, example tobacco, nicotina, cup shaped, example bottle brush. Okay, these flowers are brightly attractive and have nectar. Pollen grain get adhered to the beaks and the bodies of the birds visiting these flower attracted by nectar, and with these birds reach to other plants. Important pollinator birds are hummingbirds, sunbirds, nectarina, etc. Other example of some plant pollinated by birds are bombax, bignonia, butea and erythrina. Okay, these are the example of ornithophily plant. Next is chiroptrophily. These are bat pollinated plants. Okay, bats are nocturnal and flying mammals, and in search of nectar and insect visit the flower. In many plants, flower open during night and secrete nectar in greater quantities. Bats are helpful in pollination in such plant. For example, Anthocephalus, Bohonia, Kigelina and Adonsia. In some plants such as Ericema and some orchids, pollination take place through the help of snails, while in Goldmoor and Bombax, which are ornithophilous plant pollinated in due to squirrels. Okay, so this is the types of pollination. In this lecture we study about pollination, what is pollination, types of pollination, self pollination, cross pollination and adaptation of self pollination and cross pollination, and different kind of agencies which are responsible for pollination. In next chapter we start fertilization. Okay, fertilization. Okay, friend, thank you.